I got an email yesterday that I'll run through as quick as I can. That's like dozens of other emails that we've received and calls and everything else. Michael wrote, I'm kind of shocked at how many young people in my generation, especially in college, actually believe this stuff. My good friend and I were talking recently. He's a very calm and benevolent person who I consider very intelligent. But he told me that he's a Christian and believes that Jesus is the Son of God and blah, 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 because it all comes down to historical proof that Christianity is the only religion which has documentation on Christ's miracles according to a standard of evidence that historians justify.
Whoa!
Basically, his argument is that we have the same level of historical accuracy for Jesus and his miracles as we do for other historical figures. Is there any validity to this?
No!
I'll give my answer as I'll run through it as fast as I can because it's kind of rantish. The short answer to your question is no, there is no validity to that claim. The long answer that is that he's like millions of other Christians who are completely ignorant about what their Bible says, about the history of the biblical canon, about the history of their religion, about what evidence actually exists, about what historians have to say, about what sort of evidence historians consider sufficient to justify claims of existence, and about what sort of evidence one would need to have in order to rationally justifiably believe that a miracle has occurred. The facts are these. There are no contemporary extra-biblical accounts of any event specific to the life of Jesus. That means no independent sources from any eyewitnesses with regard to his birth, life, miracles, ministry, death, or proposed resurrection. The Gospels are anonymous. We have no original manuscripts. They do not agree on details. They do not agree with recorded history, and the consensus of New Testament scholarship is that none of them were written by eyewitnesses. The Bible has stories about eyewitnesses, but we don't have a single comment from anyone claiming to be an eyewitness. The process of canonization included books that doctrinally agreed with those in power and eliminated and attempted to destroy books that were considered heretical by those in power, yet those same books were considered inspired by other sects. Books like Revelation barely made it into the Bible, as many considered them to be uninspired. Books like The Shepherd of Hermas and The Apocalypse of Peter, which had traditionally been considered divinely inspired, were excluded. Paul's epistles, some of which are of questionable authorship, were the first books of the New Testament to be written, and that was decades after the purported life of Jesus. The Gospels were written many years later, perhaps many decades later, by unknown authors. Historians from the late 1st and 2nd century do mention Christians, and some refer to Jesus, but none of these were eyewitnesses, and most of them couldn't even have spoken to someone who claimed to be an eyewitness. So we have the Bible, a collection of stories by largely unknown authors who were unlikely to be eyewitnesses, and we don't have originals of their work. We have copies of copies of copies of translations of copies of copies of anonymous books reporting an oral tradition passed down decades or centuries after the purported events, in a time when myths, superstitions, and God-man claims were plentiful, during a time when fact-checking and literacy were rare, and when doctrinal wars prompted forged documents, Paul even mentions this in the Bible, in order to prop up competing theologies as orthodox or heretical. And for my money, that means none of it is believable. Contrast this with, for example, claims of alien abductions. You can, if you like, actually speak to people who claim to have been abducted by aliens. If you look around, you'll find groups of people who tell consistent stories and might even claim to have been abducted together. There are countless reports of UFO sightings, often by groups of people, or in rare cases, dozens or hundreds of people in a particular town or area. These reports have been ongoing for decades, reported by countless news sources, in addition to specialized periodicals. Many of these people sincerely believe their story. Do you? Does your friend? I don't, because there isn't sufficient evidence. Yet the quantity and quality of evidence for these claims is vastly superior to any miracle claims reported in the Bible. We have more evidence, and we're not 2,000 years removed from the events, and we still don't believe and find the most fervent believers to be a little crazy. Yet somehow, millions of largely ignorant, well-meaning, nice people sincerely believe third-hand reports of miracles from thousands of years ago, and they don't just believe, they strongly believe, and consider it not only absurd for others to disbelieve, but also their sacred duty to convince others at a minimum, and legislate their beliefs on others, or worse. And yet we somehow don't consider these people a little crazy. Instead, we give them special treatment, and their majority status shifts the public perception about those of us who actually embrace reality to the point where we are the ones denigrated. Your friend's probably read Josh McDowell and Lee Strobel and has never actually studied what scholars, historians, philosophers, scientists, or any other critical examiner has to say about their religion. That's the longer answer.
Nice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And yet this happens all the time.